In this video, we're going to show you how a complete dental exam is performed in an anaesthetized dog. To start with, the vet counts all the teeth and makes sure that the appropriate number of teeth are present. If there are any extra teeth or there are teeth missing, this is noted because this can cause quite serious issues later on and can affect how the mouth opens and closes and may also lead to the development of tumours and cysts that can severely affect the jaw. During this exam, we are also looking at the shape of the teeth and whether there is any food or hair accumulating between the teeth. And we look at the whole area and we check for developmental defects such as a cleft palate. Here we can see the gingival sulcus of each tooth is being probed. The normal sulcus depth in dogs is 0.5 to 3 millimeters in depth, and in cats is 0.5 millimeters. When we probe this area, we are looking for any abnormal increase in the depth of the sulcus. We can also get an idea whether the gingiva is swollen and edematous, and then if there is any recession that has occurred that may be exposing roots. Just note how every single margin of each and every single tooth is being examined. Also, how hard it is to actually reach and examine those caudal back molar teeth, those ones that we see at the very, very back of the mouth. Even though this is a blunt probe, this process would be absolutely impossible in a dog without the benefit of anaesthesia. We're also looking at the crown of each tooth, and that's the white part, and we're checking for signs of fracture, enamel wear, and pulp exposure. I want you to remember that periodontal disease affects over 70% of adult cats and 90% of adult dogs. Dental plaque is the main cause of gingivitis. And luckily for us, gingivitis is reversible with the correct dental care. However, if gingivitis is not treated, it can progress to periodontal disease. And this is a condition that's not reversible. So you can prevent gingivitis in your pets by having your vet scale and polish your pet's teeth regularly, and preferably every 6 months to a year. Just note how this exam is very different to the ones that occur in an awake dog. It's so much more thorough. When a vet performs a dental under anaesthesia, you can be absolutely guaranteed that the whole mouth is examined appropriately, and the most important area, that is under the gum line, is treated. Unfortunately, GA-free procedures just cannot do this, and they only focus on the crown and those teeth that are easily accessible, leaving your dog at risk of severe periodontal disease.